Welcome to the world of insects. Myself, Dr. Neeta Jain from Government College, Kota. How many insects are there in the world? There are more than 10 lakh species of insects in the world, and 3 out of 4 creatures on the planet are insects. Insects belong to kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, and class Insecta, also called as Hexapoda. The body of the insect is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. There is one pair of antenna on the head and 3 pairs of legs in the thorax, and also 1 or 2 pairs of wings on the thorax. This is the picture of a dragonfly divided into the 3 parts. This is again an insect because it has 3 pairs of legs. Here the scorpion and the spider, if you count, they have 4 pairs of legs, so they are not insects. Similarly, crab is not an insect because it has 5 pairs of legs. Centipede has a number of legs, so it is not an insect. The antenna of the insect is jointed. It is sensory to smell, or they are also called feelers. And the antenna can be in different types of shapes and sizes. Most of the adults have 2 pairs of wings. The anterior wing is called forewing. Posterior wing is called hind wing. Some insects are wingless. Example, silverfish, termites, ants. The wings are transparent, membranous, and they have a network of thick veins. These veins, they give support to the wings. In wings of butterflies, moths, if you touch them, the pigment comes on your fingers. That is because there are scales on the wings which are loosely fixed, so they come out, and these scales, they have pigments in them. The wings can be modified in different insects. For example, in Diptera, that is in mosquito and housefly, etc., we see that the second pair of wings is modified into a haltier. Here you can see the forewing is as such, and the hind wing has been modified into haltier. Haltier, as we know, it is used for balance. It is a balancing organ. Then in case of beetles, the forewings are hard, they are called as elytra, and the hindwings, as you can see, they are membranous. Hindwings are used for flying, and the forewings are protective in nature. Insects have compound eyes. Compound eyes, we know, they are made up of number of ommatidia. In the development of insects, there is metamorphosis. Metamorphosis means that the egg develops into a young form, and then there is molting, and it develops into an adult. Metamorphosis can be of different types. In some insects, we see there is no metamorphosis, means from the egg, the young one, it is very much similar to the adult, only it is smaller in size. In that case, it is called as ametabolous. In other insects, there can be incomplete metamorphosis, and this metamorphosis is called as is found in hemimetabolous insects. Here the eggs develop into nymphs, and then nymphs, they molt, and then they gradually change into the adult. The nymphs are very much similar to the adult, only smaller in size, and they undergo number of molting. For example, you must have seen in cockroach. Then comes complete metamorphosis. Complete metamorphosis, in which the young ones are totally different from the adult. The egg develops into a larva, the larva forms a pupa, and then from the pupa, as you can see, there is an adult, and all the four stages, they are totally different. For example, in case of butterfly, we know there is a pupa, and the larval form, as you know, is the caterpillar. Complete metamorphosis occurs in beetles, bees, flies, butterflies, etc. Now coming to the various insect orders, there are a number of insect orders. But firstly, the insect is divided, class Insecta is divided into two subclasses, pterygotes, means those insects which do not have wings, example, silverfish, Thysanura, this is pterygote. Then comes that most of the orders come under subclass Pterygota, in which there are wings, may be small or large in size. First is the Orthoptera, it is a pterygote order, first pterygote order which we are discussing. In Orthoptera we see grasshoppers, locusts, crickets, tiddi hai, jhingur hai, ye sab isme aate hai. And they have long bodies, and the how do you identify them? The hind legs, that is the third pair of legs, are extra large and they are modified for jumping. Leaf insects, mantis, cricket, all these come under Orthoptera. This is the locust, and recently you have heard a lot about locust swarming. Then comes next is Hemiptera. In Hemiptera come the bugs, like as you can see, this is the giant water bug. This is the upper one is the assassin bug. The lower picture is of a water boatman, aquatic bug. How do you identify the bugs? All these diagrams are of bugs. I'll just like to tell you about the wings found in the bugs. The bugs have hemielytra. Shall we see the previous diagram? Let's see. Yes. Here in the giant water bug, you can see the four wings, they are modified into hemielytra. Hemi means half. Out here, half of the wing, that is the proximal part, the part which is attached to the body, is hard. And on the lower side, if you can see, the overlapping part or the distal part of the wing or the tip of the wing is membranous. So, half hard and half part is membranous. This is called as hemielytra, and these types of wings are found in the bugs. Then comes Dermaptera. Dermaptera are called, the insects are called as earwigs. And if, as you can see in the picture, the posterior end, at the posterior end, there is a forceps like structure. These are the modified genitalia, and therefore, they are called as earwigs. Termites, you know about termites, they belong to Isoptera. They live in colonies, they are social insects, and there are different castes in this termites, workers, soldiers, kings and queens. All these are termites. Then comes Homoptera. In Homoptera come the cicadas, leaf hoppers, aphids. They also have piercing, sucking mouth parts like the mosquito, etc. Then lac insect also belongs to Homoptera. Lacifer, if you know, see this, the lac insect exudes or it secretes a shellac like structure, which is then processed and forms lac, which we use in the industry for making various ornaments, etc. This is On the twig you can see a number of lac insects, and they have secreted this shellac-like structure around their body, or you can say to form their homes. Then come odonates. In odonata we have dragonflies and damselflies. As we know, the dragonflies they are very fast flyers, and both of the wings they are membranous and they are used for flying. They have very large eyes also. Then comes Anoplura. Anoplura is also called as siphonculata, and in this we have sucking lice, that is, they are parasitic and they suck blood. For example, in human beings we have the pediculus, jo jise kehte hain human lice. Then comes the Coleoptera, in which we have beetles, and as I've already discussed, in the beetles the four wings are modified into totally hard structures called as elytra. The young ones of the larval forms of Coleoptera are called grubs. This is the dung beetle, as you can see, rolling the dung ball. These are the ladybird beetles, quite commonly seen. Next is Diptera. In Diptera, we have mosquitoes, flies like housefly. Why this order is called Diptera? Because there are only two wings. Ptera, Ptera means wings. So there are only one pair of wings, and the other pair of wings, as I have already told you, are modified into halteres. These are the different types of mosquitoes: Anopheles, Culex, Aedes. Okay. In Lepidoptera, we have moths, butterflies, skippers. In this case, they have siphoning mouth parts, and they suck the nectar from the flowers. They are very good pollinators. The silk moth, as you know, is used in the silk industry to produce silk material. Silk is produced from the silk moth called as Bombax mori. These are the cocoons of the silk moth, from which the silk fiber is taken out. Then there is this order Macroptera, in which come the scorpion flies. The abdominal segments are curved like the scorpion, therefore it is called as Macroptera. In Hymenoptera, we have bees, ants, and wasps. A typical feature of the Hymenoptera is there is a narrow waist. Waist matlab, jise aap kehte hain kamar, yani ki thorax aur abdomen ke beech mein body bilkul constrict ho jati, sukud jati hai, ya bahut narrow ho jati hai. So this is called as waist. And they have stings also. Then what are the various ecological uses of insecta? They are important pollinators, as we know. They help in plant reproduction. They process the plant material and wood material of dead trees and convert them into useful nutrients and in the soil. Then they are very important, you can say, constituents of the food chain, and many roaches, hoppers, caterpillars, etc., they are delicacies also. Then many of the insects, they help in biological control of other insects, like coccinella. It feeds on the aphids, which are parasitic plant parasites. Then insects are also very good bioindicators. What do we understand by bioindicator? That is a biological material which indicates or gives us the indication of the various other ecological factors. That means the insects, they can give the indication whether the ecosystem is endangered or disturbed or not. The other uses of insects are that they give honey, silk, lac, medicines like honey, wax, bee venom, cantharidin oil is also extracted from insects. What should we do for insect conservation? We should avoid indiscriminate killing of insects. We should use insects in very little amount or minimum use of insects should be done. Then minimum ecological disturbance should be done so that the insects are not harmed. Insects are also used in are also very helpful in gardening. Now these are the two insects which we in our research we have found that they are the protected species which are found in Halothi area. That is, first one is the egg fly and the other one is the common gull. These two butterflies are endangered. Now the work that we are doing in our department of zoology in Government College Kota on insects is that we are studying the various research students doing studies on insect biodiversity and what is their role as bioindicators. Biodiversity of insects has also been studied in the Jhalawad area. Biodiversity in the riverine areas of the Chambal River. Studies on the termites and the stored grain pests and their control by eco-friendly herbal insecticides.